My challenge in this video is to win the Champions League within 10 seasons. However, I'm going to be starting this journey unemployed and without a managerial job. But I've given myself some decent qualifications and experience that will hopefully earn me a job in Europe. And I have also loaded through the second tier leagues, such as the Championship or the second Bundesliga, because I need to find a club that would actually hire me. But that's not to say that I will stick by that team for the whole 10 years. Because if I do well and a better opportunity pops up, then I will certainly move to try and win the Champions League within those 10 seasons. So come and join me on this journey, on my quest to win the Champions League, starting from unemployment, because already it's the 31st of October and I have my first job interview. Wish me luck. As you can see, I've applied for every single job that's popped up. I've loaded through quite a lot of leagues, and the club that is coming first to offer me an interview is West Brom of the Championship. Now, they're not doing too well. They're currently in the relegation zone after 14 games, but it's definitely a salvageable club that if we manage to get hold of them and try and do our bit of business, we've got enough time to carry them back up the table and start earning a bit of reputation to hopefully eventually find a job in the top division. And the interview went well. Nothing too outrageous was asked, and they just want to avoid relegation for now. Other applications were getting rejected too, and I was beginning to get a little anxious. But then two things came through as Sunderland offered us an interview, and West Brom seemed to invite us back to talk about staff, which tends to mean that they're offering us the role. I decided to take up the Sunderland interview to see what they were saying, and the squad-wise, they do have a slightly better team than West Brom, and I was slightly interested, and they have a bigger budget. And with another interview coming in through Cardiff, also came the first job offer from West Brom, so now I have a decision to make. To be honest, Cardiff, I'm not really interested in. They're currently dead last. Team-wise, I think they don't have as good of players as maybe West Brom or Sunderland do. I don't know whether to wait a week and see whether Sunderland offer me the job or just go for West Brom. And the reason for that is they're kind of in the same situation anyway. I mean, what the hell Lincoln's doing in this division? Tom FM probably is manager or something. I don't know. But I might just go for the West Brom job. It's a bit of a harder challenge getting them out. But yeah, I haven't managed West Brom, I don't think, in a very long time. So I'm actually going to accept this offer. 2-year deal. Let's be the manager of West Brom. That's our new job, our first ever job in management. Now we've got 9.5 seasons to go and win the Champions League from this point, whether it's with West Brom or whether we find somewhere else. We'll probably find somewhere else. They got some good loan deals at the minute, though. They got Jarrell Kwanzaa, so some good players here at West Brom. So we need to find a tactic soon because we've got a game coming up in 3 days' time, and I'm thinking a diamond, but with a right winger. So our first game in professional football as manager takes us to Bolton, and we fall behind within 9 minutes. Thankfully, though, the lags dug deep, and in the second half, John Swift bagged us an equaliser, and we won a point. And we followed that with a win at Lincoln. Can I smell an unbeaten run coming along? And with a win at home to Reading, it sees us climb out of the relegation zone up into 18th place. So far, our start into management has been decent, and we've got West Brom playing some good football at times. By January, we've lost 3 matches since taking over, but won 3 more matches since, and also we stay in 18th place, but we're now 10 points clear of relegation. But with no money in the budget, we just kept plodding along this season, trying to get ourselves as high at the table as possible. End of season one, and we will definitely take a 17th place finish. We're avoiding all of the relegation drama by some distance as well, over 20 points. I'm really happy we decided to go with West Brom. In terms of the cups, we were never going to be really in any of it. I mean, 4th round by Fulham, which meant we, you know, did progress through the FA Cup. 3rd round by Man United, which I think even happened before I even joined. And we look at the squad, and yes, there are some good players, but I don't think this is a team that's going to really be pushing for playoff spots next season. We're just going to have to see what we can do. We haven't got a lot of transfer budget either, so I can't see us really making moves in the transfer window this summer as we go into season number 2. Job-wise, there's nothing that stands out and screams to me that we should be going for it. Obviously, we're only like 8 months into a managerial job now, and like we've avoided relegation, but we're going to be needing to be doing a lot more for a bigger club to look at us as a viable candidate for their new managerial vacancy. So for now, I'm happy to stick around as the West Brom manager this summer. I started the summer contemplating offers for Carlin Grant, who was my third choice striker, and I decided to accept and sell for 2.3 million. Don't worry though, I have a perfect replacement in Danny Ings. What a cracking player to be able to pick up for the Championship. I was kind of forced into selling our ball-winning midfielder, who kicked up a bit of a fuss and wanted to leave, so I let him go to Luton for 4.8 million. Most of my signings in season two though were long deals, such as left-footed centre-back from Chelsea Perkovic, who was start most games. One of my favourite players, Junior Krupe, also joined from Lorient, aged 19, as a striker or attacking midfielder option. The final loan signing was another striker and another player from Chelsea, as we bring in Brozier for the season as our main striker. And because of that, I've been toying around with a three-striker formation, with still with a defensive winger on the right and an advanced playmaker in behind, and it's been going really well. Because we've been picking up wins, including one against Crystal Palace near the start of the season, who have only just been relegated. And they have Endrick playing up front, on loan from Real Madrid. We only lost one game at the start of the season against Blackburn, but won the rest, meaning we end August in third place in the Championship, so hopefully that continues. And our good run of form did continue throughout the rest of the calendar year, creeping into the top two spots as we go into the 2026 with a gap to third place. So my thinking is now, we'd be quite silly to try and look at the job market and try and find a way to move to a different club, when we could potentially get promoted to the Premier League here and earn a little bit of reputation, earn a little bit of credibility, which then might actually entice a bigger club to take us on as their new manager, maybe in season three or four. And that's what I did. I stayed in my job as West Brom manager to try and gain automatic promotion. We even got to Wembley in the FA Cup semi-final to play against Liverpool and score two goals. We lost 4-2, but still, what a run. And we ended the season really close to winning the league, but it's still promotion. Listen, I'm absolutely buzzing with that. From two seasons compared to where we took over when they're in relegation zone to get automatic promotion, yeah, we've got to be really pleased. But I am wondering, what is my next step? I mean, they're giving us 40 million to go into the Premier League with, which is, you know, a good amount to be fair. But do I now look for that move? There's possibility to go to Wolfsburg there in the Bundesliga, which might be a good little option there. I mean, they finished quite low down in 12th place. Could I do some damage? They're only 8 points behind, like, European spots. Got a good enough side. They got some cracking players. Maybe I just apply, see what happens, because now that I've, you know, gained promotion, I guess, and got a good win percentage ratio, then potentially those types of clubs might take a gamble on me where they would never have done beforehand. Because to keep this team in the division in the Premier League is going to be really difficult. The top scorer was a loan signing. Probably the best player was a loan signing. Our best centre-back was a loan signing. So I'd have to replace those three positions straight away. And then obviously that's not even a good enough side to stay in the Premier League either. So I'd have to do quite a lot of money or do quite a lot of transfers with that money. So maybe trying to go for the Wolfsburg deal. I think I'm gonna apply for it and just see what happens. Unfortunately, after a few weeks waiting, my application for Wolfsburg was unsuccessful. I applied for other jobs such as the Hamburg role, but had no luck there either. So I carried on in my summer trying to sign players for this West Brom side, including bringing in a new keeper to West Brom in Kovar, who is dirt cheap and perfect for the Premier League. By the end of July, I have brought in enough new faces to hopefully improve this team to survive in the top flight while I hold out for a bigger role in Europe, not spending fortunes on anyone and picking up some free signings too. I made some tactical tweaks, but I tried the same formation and style of play and rescued a point in our first match. And we got our first win in the fourth match against Newcastle at home 5-1. So we cracked on with our season until December, when a job popped up that intrigued me. At this point, we had been plodding along, picking up points here and there with some sporadic wins and sitting mid-table with 25 points. But chilling in the bottom half of the Bundesliga is Gladbach, and they are still having a rough season and have sacked their manager. This could be a club to apply for, and it could be the next step on course to win the Champions League. West Brom were wanting to lock me down with a new contract, however, but I told them I would rather build brand new facilities, and they actually agreed to grant my request. My application for Gladbach was unsuccessful though. So once again, we cracked on with the season, but results were a little rough going into the final months. Another job popped up in AZ Alkmaar in the Netherlands. I decided to apply for that role too, but again, got rejected. And it got so bad that fans began to criticize my tactics by April. We were going through a bit of a barren spell with not a win in pretty much 3 months, and that didn't come until the final day of the season. But we survived though, and at the end of the day, a good first half of the season saved us with 41 points. No cut run this year though. Survival is all that matters, so I'm pleased with that. The job wise, there's nothing really that stands out. The Sevilla role isn't really too appealing anyway because they've got quite a lot of older players. The squad looks quite terrible really in terms of La Liga. So I think I'm going to wait and see if anything else comes up. If not, I guess we just stay with West Brom and try and keep building our reputation. I don't want to stay here past 5 years. I think I need to give myself 5 years of going for the big clubs to win that Champions League trophy. My goal this summer is to drop a striker into the midfield, so selling Maja for this amount to Luton would be awesome to add to our small budget of just 20 million, so hopefully he does want to leave. It worked immediately, and he was sold to Luton for £26 million. We only got 70% of the transfer from Maja, but as a backup, I brought in Diogo Gonçalves, as he can play both sides and through the middle, so he covers every midfield position that we use for £8 million. But on the left, I brought in Luka Ivanišek because of his pressing abilities from Feyenoord for £7 million. My idea for this season is to be very press-heavy and bring players in with good work rates and try to catch our opponents out in a mid-to-high block. I did bring in a third striker with Vitinha joining the club, who can be a great presser too, for just £6 million. We also let Jed Wallace go, so Castile comes in on a free transfer. However, we did lose Kovar to Saudi Arabia as they match his release clause, which is heartbreaking as he's my number one. So I brought in an older keeper with a lot of experience to be our number one this season from Braga. We are still bringing in players, but you can see here the pressing system was working really well and we beat Brighton on the opening day 1-0. As I say, players are still coming in and we brought in a hard working and aggressive winger in Strivetsa for just £1 million. The final signing was Nauf, another winger that we picked up from Frankfurt for just short of £10 million. I don't know if it's a sign of things to come, but we currently sit top of the league after an unreal start to the season. During October, though, a lot of jobs started to pop up, including Atalanta, another job that could be a step up for us to get. However, yet again, we're unsuccessful. By the new year, though, West Brom are sitting pretty in 7th place currently, which I will take. Not to mention the football we are playing is high-pressing, direct, attacking, and beautiful to watch too. And we are going into the final stages of the season, sat in 6th place, and we're in the semi-final of the FA Cup, a semi-final against Spurs in which we played fantastically well at Wembley and come away as 2-0 winners to go into the final, which takes us once again to Wembley against Manchester United. And at the end of the Premier League season, we sit in 7th place with a fantastic 66 points. But in the FA Cup final, we have to come from behind and Vitinha scores a worldie, and that is to lift the trophy. A fantastic win, but there's some jobs that have popped up now that my eyes are glued to, and it's time to leave. There's no doubt that this was a cracking season, but it's not our end goal to do well with West Brom, unfortunately for you Baggy fans. We need to win the Champions League, which means we need to win we need to find a Champions League club. I still don't know whether we're at that point yet where we can get the jobs which can take us into the Champions League, but there are some that's popping up. Now, Napoli have just won the league in the Serie A. I've applied for it. I don't think I'm going to get it. I don't know why their manager has been sacked. Like, that's very weird. They got sacked, but it's like, you just won the league. Why would you sack Rebroff? But anyway, we've applied for the job either way. Leipzig might be the one that would be a possibility that we get an interview because their reputation's 4-star. I think ours is 3.5-star now after that win. So Graham Potter is the leading candidate, but it's only just come up 7th in last season in the Bundesliga. Arsenal are 5th place. I very much doubt we're going to get the Arsenal job. They're a little bit higher in reputation in terms of things like that. If we can get it, fantastic. But I would prefer to go to a different country. I feel like I don't want to be stuck in the Premier League. Kind of want to move away from it. So let's see what comes of these three. Maybe there's more jobs that pop up. Imagine my shock when the first role I hear about is the Arsenal one, who are actually going to give me an interview. Hilariously though, they consider a move from West Brom to Arsenal as a sideways move. Straight after, Leipzig came in as well, offering us an interview, and this is the role that I think is a much more realistic prospect. But the day I thought would never come, as finally we were rejected from Napoli and have been demanded to speak to the West Brom board, but Leipzig have offered us the job, and I'm accepting a two-year contract. And we go into the fifth season manager of Leipzig, definitely a step up, and there's some fantastic players at this club too. Sad news is Leipzig don't actually have any transfer budget left. The good news though is that they already have a cracking team and plenty of talent that we could potentially move on from the bench and beyond that can come on and also make a difference on the pitch. This squad is absolutely huge, so as I mentioned, I sold a few players including Werner, who was on 100k a week nearly. Jashari is also leaving the club for 20 million, as well as Zafiris, who leaves for 18 million pounds, freeing up some cash. We loaned in Lenny Yoro as a starting centre-back option from Manchester United, as Auburn is a little bit old and slow. And we actually spent the rest of our transfer budget on another Manchester United player in Lorenzo Luca. We kicked off the season with a 1-0 win. It wasn't pretty, but we definitely got the job done. And by January, we had two problems. We weren't playing too well and down in seventh spot. But the second problem is that we lost our best player in the transfer window, thanks to Manchester City, who matched his release clause, and that's not great. But I brought in an old friend as a replacement, Junior Krupe, who of course helped us gain promotion with West Brom in the Championship. And he comes in as a starter in a new system I've been working on, and it's been going well. And Junior Krupe has started just as we hoped, fitting into it perfectly. Bayern did win the league with six games remaining, and we are still fighting for the Champions League spots. And with two games left, we are just a couple of points off of the Champions League spots behind Wolfsburg, who's actually our next game in fact. And despite being away from home, we were relentless against them and really turned up the pressure for a late run at the Champions League spots, winning the game 3-0, scoring all three goals in just a 15-minute period during the second half. On the final day of the season though, we battered Bochum 5-1 with Junior Krupe scoring two and getting two assists, a man of the match performance, and rightfully give us the qualification for the Champions League that we desired. We did also make the DFB Pokal Cup final, but it's Bayern who's our opponents. However, in Berlin, the most outrageous match took place with 9 goals being scored. And somehow, we come out as victorious as 5-4 winners. That is an absolutely outrageous performance, by the way, because I'm pretty sure they stuffed us right near the end of the season. But we'll take it. It's a cracking season. We managed to get to the Champions League qualifications, which was our ultimate goal. We won the cup, which means reputation-wise, that's growing for future job prospects. We did do very well in the Europa Conference League, knocked out by Midtjylland. But that's fine. Transfer budget, we haven't got that much. The finances aren't fantastic here in Leipzig right now, but we're all good. And job-wise, there's nothing that's popped up that I'm like, oh, that's perfect for us to move to right now. I'm kind of happy sticking around in Leipzig for another at least half a season or season, and then see what we can do maybe in year 7 through to 10. I do still think that we need one more move, though. I like this Leipzig side. I just don't know. I feel like we need one more big step up to a bigger team that can take us to Champions League glory. Until then, we need to keep improving the team, which helped when Al Hilal activated David Ram's release clause of 43 million. Because we replaced him with Rugeri, who I think is a much better player and younger, for just 27 million. On the right side of defence, we also need an improvement, so I also brought in Vanderson from Barcelona for 23 million. A new keeper to challenge our number one came through the door in Ramage from Germany, who only cost 20 million pounds from Inter Milan. Rafa Marin was the last first team option to come in at centre back, again for just 23 million. Quite a lot of players around that price range. And I'm kind of settled on the tactic now, and I think we've got a lot of options to try and challenge in all competitions. And we've certainly started well this season, and we're scoring a lot of goals. It's just the silly results that keep costing us in this title race so far. And even sillier results, meaning that we went into the knockout playoffs of the Champions League, where Villarreal beat us over two legs. It was a bad season in terms of, like, we didn't really win anything. Domestically, we kind of recouped ourselves, but we still finished 8 points behind Bayern Munich. Like, they are just very difficult right now. So I feel like even in Europe, we're going to struggle because there's teams just way better than us. And if we're losing to the likes of Villarreal, we're clearly nowhere close. We can't even win the DFB Pokal yet. Job-wise, I don't know whether there's anything that's cracked up that I'm thinking, oh, that's a really good move to go for. I mean, there's only really the Leverkusen, they're in our league, we're higher than them, there's no really much point. So the next step, I think, will come during the season next year, which I think we go into year 7. So if we find a job during that season, it kind of gives us like 3.5 years to win the Champions League, which is doable. We've got £83 million to improve this side, but players are aging. I don't know. Let's see what we can do. A lot needs to be done, though, if we are to win the Champions League anytime soon. However, just two players came through the door at Leipzig, starting with Jason van Duyven, who has developed into a cracking striker and will help our strike force, and Aslanu, who might not start every game, but is a really good rotation for the midfield. And it's a bit of a mixed bag at the start of the season, though, as we won, lost, and drawn in our first three Bundesliga fixtures. But throughout the season, I had one eye on the job market to see if any interesting roles popped up. And as we got into January, while chasing an unbeaten Bayern Munich in the league, a job came up as insecure that intrigued me. Liverpool. Maybe a trip back to the Premier League with a team that currently has Lamine Yamal might be on the cards. However, I kept track of that job as well as a few others, but no board pulled the trigger to fire the current manager. And Leipzig were eliminated by a very average Napoli side in the round of 16 of the Champions League. Bayern Munich went invincible in the Bundesliga 2, and I knew it was time to move. And that's when a dream job came up. Yes, I'm excited by this job prospect because at the end of the season, Inter Milan have sacked their manager. Third place finish. They have got a cracking team, by the way. Lautaro Martinez is still there. They've got Jeremy Pino. They've got Javi Guerra, nice little Spanish link in there. They've got some cracking new gens as well that's in the lineup. Dura is one of the centre-backs I tried to go for previously, but rejected me. Really good players, as you can see from this whole squad. And they have a budget of £269 million. I should be able to build a team good enough to challenge and win the Champions League with this Inter Milan side. So, I mean, I have to apply for the job. I have to. And declare interest. This could be the perfect role for me to get. After a few weeks of waiting, Inter Milan finally respond and invite us to an interview. I just hope they haven't spent all of the budget yet. But it seems like we smashed the interview because they came back just a few days later and offered us the job. And I genuinely believe this is the team to do it. And even though we've got all of these phenomenal players, we still have the £269 million to add more to make this a Champions League winning team. And I have a plan to make us more defensively solid than what we were at Leipzig, and these three players coming in are just the guys we need. Starting off with Bajcetic, who comes in for the most amount of money, and that's weird considering he's actually the player out of the three that probably won't get into my best 11. He just covers so many roles perfectly. The cheapest out of the three is from Lens and is called Kumara, who is a left-sided player who can play on the wings or up front, but is definitely more suited for that left-sided midfield. But prepare yourself for the best signing of the summer and probably of the video, a ball-winning midfielder from Reims by the name of Maxwell Mbom, who quite frankly is fantastic and just 20 years old. His mentals and his physical attributes make him the perfect ball-winning midfielder for my side. And my plan is to use him in this invincible tactic that I set up with Barcelona from the rebuild versus Dad, but changing the Regista role into a ball-winning midfielder for Mbom. In Europe, I kept losing silly games with Leipzig last season, and I need something much more structurally defensive to allow my creative players to win the games for me. And to say that it's been off to a good start would be a bit of an understatement, because we've won our first three games, including stuffing both Lazio and our main rivals AC Milan 4-1. And Mbom isn't just a ball-winning midfielder, but a threat from set pieces too. And after 20 games of the league campaign, we're still unbeaten, just trailing champions Napoli, who have played a game more and 3 points ahead. It hasn't been that easy in the Champions League though, as we lost two games to AC Milan and Real Madrid and drew to Celtic and Chelsea. However, I can't believe I'm about to say this, but a Besiktas side led by Jadon Sancho ended our run in Europe in season number 8, knocking us out 4-1 on aggregate and beating us in both legs. Domestically, we actually went all the way to the end of April before losing a game against Roma, but the league was still close despite this. Honestly, Napoli are phenomenal in this. They only lost two games. One of them was against us, the other was against the other Milan, but they finish on 100 points, we finish on 101. Imagine having 100 points and not winning the league. Like, that is insane. They took us all the way down to the wire, all the way to the last game. And they even beat us in the Coppa Italia final 1-0-2. So we only lost two games all season, and we just won the league by 1 point and didn't manage to win the cup, which is mental. Don't talk to me about this Champions League. I have no idea how Besiktas has managed to do this. Van Bronckhorst is the manager. I don't understand what's happened. Napoli, by the way, is actually managed by Arne Slot, so Liverpool fans might be happy with that. They've got some cracking players in there. I just don't think they're like world class compared to like where we are. This player is phenomenal, one of the best attacking midfielders in the game. But the rest of their side is not like unbelievable. In terms of my side, I definitely think this tactic is the way to go. It's really good in terms defensively, and yet we're still scoring goals. But Jeremy Pino's picked up the most, and what a season he's had. 34 with 19 assists, 34 goals for Lautaro Martinez. He is 34 years of age now as well. He is wanting to go. I don't want to lose him, but what I do want to do is bring in a more of a first teamer, because I think I believe we can get more goals out of a striker than that. We've got a couple of good options. There's one out on loan here. He's quite good, to be fair. He's 19, but I've got my eye on an Italian striker who I noted last season made a move, and I think he could be the one. So maybe we go for him, but I'm really happy with the side, really happy with Mbombo. I mean, he's actually developing again, which that's mental. Like, he's got even better. And we have £247 million to chuck into the transfer market again. This should be a fun summer. So I got to work in the transfer window, spending a lot of money, and brought in that Italian striker I alluded to earlier, who I think could start most games for us next season. And he has definitely hit the ground running back in the Serie A. But to get any player out of this Napoli side, I had to spend a lot of money, which is why I spent £200 million on what I think is the best left back I could find, because it's the only position I believe we needed an improvement. The rest of the side kind of picks itself, really, and there is a lot of options for replacements now. But it's time to go deep in that Champions League for the first time. Which, of course, starts in the league phase, where we had some cracking results happen, like 4-0 against Liverpool, and an Adesi worldie being scored. It still wasn't perfect, despite us finishing fourth, as we lose to Man City and draw to Young Boys and Atletico Madrid. In the round of 16, however, we lost the first leg to Arsenal 2-1 at the Emirates. Off the bench in the second leg, though, Martinez scored a 93rd minute penalty to take it to extra time before going on to score the winner in the 114th minute, scraping us through to the quarterfinals against Bayern Munich. Once again, the first leg away from home was a defeat by a single goal, and we needed an extra time after winning 2-1 to go on to find a winner, which we managed to do. The semi-final away to Chelsea, though, was lit up thanks to Mbom, who scored a scorcher, and that man of the match performance capped off a 3-0 first leg win. We lost the second leg but still progressed through to the final, and the final was being played against Manchester City, but it wasn't the only final we go in, as we sought out revenge against Napoli in the Coppa Italia, and still haven't quite yet secured the league yet. Napoli missed a penalty to go 2-0 up, and we punished them for it, as Adesi was on form and scored the two goals to give us the win and lift the Coppa Italia. And we held on to get back-to-back league titles too. Now it's just one trophy left for us to win, and we've made it to the final in season number 9. From unemployment to the Champions League final, and we definitely have the team to lift this trophy. So I'm excited. And if you haven't done so already, you need to be pressing that subscribe button, because what are you doing? You haven't pressed the subscribe button. We're nearly at 150K now, and you can help us get there. But this Manchester City side, Wirtz, Foden, Haaland, Rico Lewis, Guardiola, all still there. Hitate is a good player as well. But can they defeat this 4-1 that we've got? I've gone with Adese up front. My heart said to go for Lautaro Martinez. My head said to go for Adese. But as the boys line up, the nerves are really kicking in. I wasn't ready. I looked away. We've scored from kickoff. No way. Jeremy Pino hits the byline, Adesi scores, and within 32 seconds, the ball has hit the net, and we're 1-0 up. Oh, now we got a free kick. Barella steps over. Come on. Have a good pop. What a worldie of a free kick. Nicolò Barella, it's 2-0. Oh my word, we are so close already. Just please do not screw this up now. Come on, nothing silly. We've started amazingly well. Oh my god, there's more. Epink. Adesi down the left. Can you find someone? Back to Epink. Have a pop if you like, lad. Have Higuera, mate. No, back to Mbom. Look where he's just positioned, just perfectly there. His passing's not great, I'll give him that, but hey, Dura, nothing silly. There we go. You got the machine running after you. Jeremy Pino. Oh, he's took it down the wing beautifully. Gives it to Barella. Mbom. Oh, he can hit a bomb. We know that. We've already seen it. Oh, corner ball from Man City. Haaland. Ah, that's annoying, isn't it? We could have done without that, to be honest. Set pieces. Who's marking him? Who's that? Adesi. Why have we got Adesi marking him? Why is that happening? I don't even think he's that tall, is he? Oh, he is 6'3 with 17 jumping reach, but I mean, marking six. You don't put somebody who's terrible at marking in on Erling Haaland. You put Mbom on there or Bastoni, surely. We got a corner of our own, though. To Pino. We've gone short for ours. Maybe a penalty? No. Bastoni picks it up, though. Epink. I hate it when you run back and there's like nobody there. Terraciano. Find somebody if you can. Dora. Uh-oh. That's a nice ball. Back to Pino. Cross it in. Now you've got time and space. Oh, what are we doing? Oh, he's in. Oh, this is a long-ass highlight. And Foden has got it. Oh, Foden's jinked him. Foden scores with his right foot. I mean, we're trying to make this game realistic. Come on. It's 2-2. Well, that lead disappeared quite quickly, didn't it? But we go in at halftime. Still within a chance. Conceded two silly goals. We scored two fantastic ones. And we have the ball in the 49th minute here. Mbom to Javi Guerra. Mbom's just there all the time. Like, look at him. Just always there. He's just a monster of a man. He is absolutely huge. Kamara, Mbom's there if you need him. Oh, he's got it as well. Oh, lovely play. Adesi, how have you missed that? And he's onside. That's shocking. That is really poor. Oh, don't say we're going to concede now. I'll take him straight off. He's on a 7.2. I'll take him straight off. Lautaro Martinez, get yourself warmed up, lad. Hatate, Verts, Haaland's in. Corner ball. Not again. Oh my God, nearly happened again. Oh, I've made some changes. Martinez is on the pitch. Sars come on the pitch. Duranville's on the pitch as well. Three changes. We've got about 15 minutes left. But we might also have extra time. But there's some time and space for Duranville. Just come on. Oh, so much space. Prieto. Where's our press then? Where's our press? It's non-existent. And Erling Haaland has run through. And Erling Haaland has scored in the Champions League final. Again, by the way. Corner ball though. And we've gone short. Pino. Oh, Lautaro. Gotta be. There's two. Which one do you want, ref? We'll take both. We'll take consecutive penalties and we'll go 4-3 up. Gone to VAR. Surely one of them's got to be a penalty. It is as well. And Lautaro Martinez is the penalty taker. Now he's on the pitch. Come on. Pop it in the net, lad. Get in. Come on. 5 minutes to go. And we're back in it. I'm sweating. Gone to extra. Is that guy not got a shirt on? What is he sat on as well? Stick a shirt on, lad. There'll be kids watching this. It's gone to extra time. Oh no. Martinez has got injured. Right, luckily, we've actually got two options off the bench. We've got Panaz, who is a really good striker. He's unbelievable. He's only 20 years of age. He hasn't played many games. We loaned him last season. He got 16 goals in the Serie A, so he can't be too bad. He's going to come on the pitch now, and we've got one sub left. Extra time is winding down. I think it's going to be pens. Oh, dear. We don't have a lot of good penalty takers on the pitch either. And it starts off with Erling Haaland again. Come on, miss. He doesn't do that very often, does he? As we've seen, Jeremy Pino. He's been fantastic for us. Come on. Yes, in we go. 1-1. I never really like going second either. I always feel like that's a disadvantage. Doku. Saved. Come on. Mbom's next. Look at him, the monster. Mbom. The ball-winning midfielder. Oh, should stick to winning the ball back. That's not good, is it? Florian Mertz to take the third penalty, and he doesn't miss. I told you we haven't got a lot of good penalty takers. Barella's up next. Experienced Barella. He's like 35 now. Come on, pop it in the net. Come on, there we go. Dennis Seaman almost saved it. Two German goalkeepers here. Curtis Jones. Curtis Jones is going to take a penalty. Scores. Here comes Panaz, though. It would have been Lautaro Martinez. He is penalty taker, as we've seen. But Panaz steps up. Panaz scores. 20-year-old in a Champions League final. The absolute gohonads on the poor lad. Bulot. Come on, miss. Oh, I thought he saved it. It's down to Saar, I think. Oh, he's a bloody Spurs player. He's gonna miss, isn't he? He's a Spurs player. We all know what's gonna happen now. Saar steps up. Oh, that's a good penalty. Hell of a run-up as well. He didn't even stop. Aaron Hickey for Manchester City. The left foot of Aaron Hickey is saved. And now we just need to score to win the Champions League. And who is it going to be? It's Julian Duranville. I don't feel positive. From unemployment to Champions League winners. Yes! We've done it. Come on. From West Brom to Leipzig to Inter Milan. From unemployment to the Champions League winner. Thank you very much for watching. Make sure you subscribe as we lift the trophy of the Champions League before you now. And please, go on and watch this video right here because Bordeaux are in a lot of trouble right now. They need me. Go and watch it. It's a cracking video. Make sure you subscribe.